Yo, this man just hit me in my face with a brick, and all these black men just watched.
Houston police got called to this street in September, and when they arrived, the woman seen in that viral video told them that an Uber driver threw a brick at her head and then tried to kidnap her. Criminal investigation, because Houston police say the surveillance footage doesn't match her story. Harris County Prosecutor Keith Houston says surveillance videos from that early September morning show Osman hitting a man first.
So she's the one she was the aggressor.
She was the aggressor, yes.
And it was a water bottle that hit her, not a brick?
He did have a water bottle in his hand, and we think that's what left the mark. He told the detective that responded that she was hit in the head with a brick after she refused to give her phone number to a guy on the street.
And was that verified by any of the evidence that detectives looked at?
No. That was not verified.
According to court documents, she asked someone else to launch this GoFundMe for her recovery. But as the story went viral, a blogger on TikTok called police, alerting them to this 2020 GoFundMe, which claimed a vicious assault by a security guard in Minneapolis.
It was completely fictional.
Prosecutors allege theft by deception and believe she would have received all that money had the campaign not been shut down. Tonight, she is wanted here in Harris County on that theft charge. Anyone with information on her whereabouts can report that to Houston police.
Can't say I didn't try. It might make me cry. Oh, it might hurt, no lie. Miss you, but goodbye.
Everybody, I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. Before you type anything down below, there's a quite plethora of y'all that owe me an apology. Okay, for all of y'all that was out here calling me a mammy, calling me a pick me, like, run it. Bitch, run it. I need that shit now. I apologize. I didn't mean to come in here with that energy today. How are you? Comment down below. I'd love to know how you guys are. You know, we're halfway through the month. I've actually been going through a lot, and it kind of annoys me that I had to come on camera to make this video because I had so many videos already preset, but I had to come on camera to discuss this because I already made an initial video when all of this happened. As we all already know, and as you guys can tell by the title, today we are going to be talking about Rhoda Osman. If you did not watch my first initial video I made about this situation, it will be linked down below. Or if for whatever reason you can't reach it, I forget, just type in the Mademoiselle Brickgate, it will pop up. This situation was literally one of the craziest stories of 2023, and it has now been laid to rest. Well, not really, because we all know more shit is gonna continue to come out, okay? If you guys are not aware by now, Rhoda is now facing felony charges and has a warrant out for her arrest at the time that I'm filming this video. I swear to God, this always happens when I literally film a video early, okay? So apparently, allegedly, Rhoda is on the run. However, she claims that she's not on the run, okay? So that's why I'm saying allegedly.
We got alerted earlier today that Ms. Osman, that Brick Lady, was planning to surrender and turn herself in because she's wanted for theft in Harris County. We were contacted by the New Black Panther Nation and Quanel X because he was contacted by her for help and to arrange the surrender. So it was our understanding that that was supposed to happen at 3:45 today. You can see right now it's that time has passed. And as we arrived here at Houston Police Headquarters today, we got another alert that Ms. Osman, Brick Lady, is a no-show. She decided to not surrender. I spoke with Candace Matthews, part of the New Black Panther a nation. And she told me that they had an agreed meeting location today. They were supposed to be meeting with Brick Lady and then bringing her here for the surrender at Houston Police Headquarters. But they say she didn't show up. She didn't provide an explanation. And Candace Matthews tells us that this is really the first time that something like this has happened. People reach out to them often. You know, we are usually aware when they've been contacted, and sometimes, you know, they do arrange for surrenders and then tell the media and provide comments in person. So we were expecting exactly that to happen here at HPD today. But again, a little bit weird. Something changed. We don't know what changed. And so now, Brick Lady remains on the run.
Things may progress as I edit and post this. However, that is the official news as it is right now that I'm filming this on a Thursday afternoon, all right? Of course, all of us already know the basics of this story, so I don't really have to rehash too much of that. In September, Rhoda came out in a since then viral video saying that she was attacked by a black man with a brick, and a bunch of black men stood there and did absolutely nothing. Since then, there's been so many people who have come forward to discredit her story as well as prove her story. The issue here is a lot of the people that were doing both those things didn't necessarily have too much proof. This created such a huge gender war. Let me not say created, made the existing gender war between the black community so much worse, because it really had a lot of people talking. A lot of black men in particular were showing their asses. Like, it was crazy. You had black men coming out saying they don't defend no black women. You had black women coming out saying they don't trust black men. It was a very tumultuous situation. I will say, regardless of the situation being true or not, we did see how a lot of black men do feel about us. And I'm not even gonna let y'all come on here and be like, this situation, da 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 da. But at the same time, this is what the fuck happens when y'all sitting here and y'all give validity to scammers and liars and bullshitters, because now it gives people ammo to use against us. Now, before I even get into the rest of this video, let me just say, for all of y'all fucking annoying ass bitches, okay? Because I already know this video is gonna get demonetized or age restricted, whatever, I don't give a shit. For all y'all dumbass bitches that was sitting here calling me all types of mammies and whatever, and all y'all niggas that be out here calling me all types of degenerates and far from bald-headed, it's all my hair, calling me all types of crazy shit, I don't understand. Why is it that the black community, when someone is saying something that you don't like, you automatically resort to disrespecting them and trying to make it seem like they're not saying anything credible because you don't like their opinion? Understand, okay? I have my own fucking opinions, and my opinions are my own. I don't wanna think like you. I don't wanna think like them. I don't wanna think like her. I don't wanna think like him. I've always had my own opinion. Stop comparing me to this, that, and the third. Don't put me in no fucking community with no fucking body. I am my own fucking person. That's why when this shit came out and everybody was out here getting attacked, I left my video as is, because I knew what the fuck I said in that video was fact at that damn time. It doesn't make any sense to me how every single time I make a video regarding the black community, whether it's black women or black men, and I'm holding black men or black women accountable, y'all get fucking upset. Let me tell you this right now, black men, black women, go fucking heal, dead ass. That is why this whole situation is happening, and other situations like this will continue to happen. You all hate each other. We hate each other. That's the problem here. Y'all hate black men. Y'all hate black women. When something like this happens, you find every little situation to nitpick at people. And then when people sit here and call out the complete nonsense in it, all of a sudden, oh, well, you a mammy, you a pick me, you a bald-headed bitch, you ain't shit, you're this, that. Like, seriously? Be fucking for real. Everybody was sitting here not using their common sense, and I've never in my life seen something like it. All right, so let's just get into what was fact and what was not. All right, so now let's start from the top of the line now, shall we? Let me grab my drink. If you guys didn't get your merch from my shop yet, please go do so. Shout outs to all of you guys who have already gotten my merch. Since a lot of the details are very, very murky, still, when all you have to do is read the article. First things first, was she hit with a brick? No. Then what was she hit with? According to the news articles and the police investigation, she was hit in an altercation with a grown-ass man who, which a lot of you guys are so confused about, especially if you are on TikTok and Instagram where this is going viral, had a water bottle in his hand and hit her with the water bottle in his hand. She was not hit in the face with a water bottle. They did not throw a water bottle out of her face. She literally got into a fight with a grown-ass man, and he punched her in the face and happened to have a water bottle in his hand. I don't know if it was something like this that was metal. I don't know if it was a plastic Poland Spring bottle. I don't know if it was a jug, but that's what the shit says. Nonetheless, the fact is she got into an altercation, aka mutual combat, with a grown man. That is why she has a knot on her face. For whatever strange reason, a lot of people are failing to realize that even after I posted my video and many other people posted their videos, this girl has done this numerous times. This is not her first GoFundMe. This is not the first time she has blamed black men for her nonsense. And this is not the first time that she has sat here crying wolf about someone attacking her. Even after the situation happened, she got attacked again.
I was like so happy to report, like, this is my first weekend out without having a panic attack. But then I got actually attacked physically. As you can see, I have a welt right here and a little welt right here. Don't worry, those bitches cannot fight. But two black women in their 40s decided to attack me as I was leaving the establishment.
And they mad because you trying to fucking be somebody. They mad because you trying to be somebody. I'm trying to be a doctor and they mad. Look what they did to me. Look what they did to me for no reason. They gonna beat me up. I'm 30 years old, they gonna beat me up. Grown ass niggas try to beat me up. Grown ass niggas try to beat me up for no reason. Look at me. I'm not a bad person, y'all know that. Y'all know I'm a good person. And they try to do this to me. Guess what? It's up and down for a real nigga. But you gonna be a pussy all your life, nigga. All your life you gonna be a pussy. All your life you gonna be a pussy. And I fought for myself because I'm a gangsta ass bitch. What's up? Hoy da yu eko dala was. Inka eko gya do okor da aya. Ani my goodness, I am not get saka. Hoy da. It's up and down for a real nigga. But you gonna be a loser all your life, nigga. Trying to beat up a woman for fucking leaving and doing something with your life when your ass is fucking a loser all your life, nigga. You can't beat me up. You can't. It's all good. They gave me a real good shiner though. Grown ass niggas. Over fucking 6 feet tall. Losers. Loser ass niggas. Up and down for a real nigga. But you gonna be a loser all your life, nigga.
Make it make sense. Next, we have the GoFundMe. So she did raise over $42,000. However, allegedly, it was never dispersed to her. That's why you saw a lot of people like,
hey, please send money to Rhoda because she really, really needs the help. The money's not being given to her, blah, blah, blah.
Apparently, GoFundMe got wind of her scams and really was sitting here like, something's not right here.
And tonight, a spokesperson for GoFundMe telling KPRC2 the fundraiser has been removed from the platform. All donors have been refunded, and Rhoda Osmond has been banned from using the platform for any future fundraisers.
Now, a lot of you guys are probably like, wait, so if that's the case, why is she being charged with a felony and basically has a warrant out for her arrest if technically she didn't get the money? Well, she raised the money under false pretenses. She said she was hit with a brick by a man and then continued to raise that money with those specific lies. Now, for those of you guys who just don't understand yet, the DA, prosecutor's office, all of that, they're never going to try to press charges against you and bring something to court, trial, or anything like that if they do not think that they can win. Okay, yes, they lose cases all the time, but if they know that it's not an airtight case, they're not even gonna try to do that. So this has been investigated already. Her friends that were with her also admitted that she was not hit with a brick. Now, obviously, I just told y'all what happened to her face. Celine's situation, not accurate. The situation with the allergic reaction in her face, not accurate.
Now, because we are practicing accountability in 2024 and beyond and before, I will apologize for putting that theory out there and I guess accelerating it among everyone else, because to be quite honest, even though there wasn't proof, we were all searching for an answer as to why her face was like that if she wasn't hit. I always did believe that she was hit. However, even though I did say allegedly in my last video, I would like to apologize for saying that there may have been saline injected into her face or that she may have had an allergic reaction. I didn't feel like going back and watching my video right now as I'm editing to go see if I specifically said that, but if I did, I'm very sure I said allegedly, but whether I did or did not, I do want to apologize for that.
To be quite honest, I don't know where all these people came left field saying all of this extra shit, including that man that came forward saying that he saw her get hit and he did nothing about it and he don't care. We already disproved that in my last video. Never happened. He was never at the scene. There were so many people coming forward just trying to get clout off of this situation. And everyone believed this specifically because it was on the internet, it got views, and it was believable at the time. But what a lot of you guys need to understand is that just because something's on the internet, and just because someone says something, just because someone is a black man or a black woman, or you have some sort of relation to them, or you can relate to something that's happened to them, doesn't necessarily mean that they're telling the truth. Multiple things can be true at the same time. And furthermore, we have the police reports, the hospital records, and everything that she posted. To be quite honest with you, this is what really tripped the police up and what honestly got her caught, because there was no initial police report like filed at the police station. However, the police were there and they asked her what happened, and then they followed up with her, and each time they asked her the story, her story consistently changed. Even when you see the hospital report, it does not say she was hit with a brick. However, it does say that she was hit. Most people that were sitting here talking about this and saying she was a liar never said she didn't get hit. But that's not true. There was a lot of people saying that she didn't get hit. I believe she got hit. I was just like, Judging by her history and judging by the fact that she's done this before, she more than likely just got in a fight and got knocked upside her head. That was my logic. And look at me being right. That is some crazy shit, bro. So nonetheless, a lot of people really just believed her because, you know, she put out her own shit. But none of us were ever really able to find a legit police document. And that's because every single time the police asked her for her statement, it continuously changed. Many bloggers, YouTubers, shit, journalists even were calling Houston PD, you, if for whatever reason you don't give a shit about what I'm saying, you don't care what anybody else is saying, you there can call Houston PD and ask them, hey, what is the follow-up on the case of Rhoda Osmond? What is going on? They will tell you. It's not that hard. There were people, there was this one bitch in particular talking about, oh, you're lying in our face. You can't always look up things if it's public record, blah, blah, blah. Like, you stupid ass bitch. Most of the time it is public record. That shit was not closed at the time. It was too goddamn early. There was nothing fucking there. Olan Douglas. Unless his name has been dragged through the mud a little bit too much, I'ma just leave that shit there, okay? More than likely, that was him that got into a fight with her. However, mbakone. Okay, I'ma leave that there. It is what it is. He did get into an altercation with a man, but moving on. Now, I know a lot of you guys are probably like, but what about that article that NBC wrote? My name's Ivana, and I graduated from Bloomfield College in 2017 with a bachelor's in communications and a concentration in broadcast journalism. I used to really want to be a news anchor. Then I switched it to being a radio host. But YouTubers make way more, so now I'm here. And I didn't want motherfuckers to tell me what the hell did I do. Okay, there's a reason you didn't see major news sources covering this story, because none of it made sense. There were no real hardcore facts. And on top of that, Rhoda was out here just putting shit on her social media, spinning her own narrative, and the cops had absolutely nothing to give the media. The media corresponds with official reports from police and other authority officials and things of that sort. There was such a disconnect here that there was never any real official news stories until now, because now they did their investigation, okay? Now, what a lot of you guys are failing to realize is that nonsense NBC or whatever article that was written is an opinion piece, okay? Listen closely. There's different types of articles that all types of online publications post, okay? That was a video essay slash opinion piece. It was not a news article. This is how you could tell the difference. A news article will always have the what, where, why, when, and how. Okay, that is how journalists are typically taught how to write. Journalists are not only supposed to have those details, they're supposed to only have fact, have no opinions, and in most cases, they're supposed to show both sides of a story. And of course, there's journalistic integrity that we are supposed to follow, but most of us don't. I'm a YouTuber, I ain't gotta follow that shit, I don't work for no station, but I do try to have some integrity, and when I'm wrong, I say that I'm wrong, as with most news stations. But this story, they couldn't do that. That is why you didn't see anything. When it came to that article, and you guys kept tagging me and tagging all these other people in it, in this case, it's she's being charged, but if that would have been written back then, it wouldn't have even been able to be written. Now, when it comes to that article that you guys kept sending and or an opinion piece, but it was mainly analyzing what this situation has done to the Black community as a whole, especially in further feuding the gender wars. That shit was not a news article. It was not necessarily, I don't want to say it wasn't credible. It was a fucking essay. Like, anybody could write an essay. It's an opinion piece, but that's not news. That's why that was the only one you saw. That person took it upon themselves to write an opinion piece because I guess they believed her. And then you guys were sitting there like, oh, well, there's stuff attached to it. The same shit that the girl's been posting on her Instagram for the past couple months. Y'all, we have to do better.
Yeah, that's mainly an interview as well as an opinion piece. No news elements whatsoever, except for telling us what we already knew. That's why that was literally the only one we saw.
It's okay to be wrong. Scammed us, okay? Who had everybody out here crying, hooping, hollering, yelling at the top of their lungs, and to find out that they're a fucking liar. Look at Carly Smollett. We need a new name for this one. Comment down below, what's a good name for this one? Because to be honest, I couldn't even think of one. I just had to run to the camera. I couldn't even think of a damn name. The point that I'm trying to get at is it's okay to admit that you're wrong. I don't understand why people are still defending this girl. I don't understand why you guys don't understand that by defending this girl, you're making it so much harder for Black women. You're making it so much harder for true victims. You're making it so much harder for yourself because you're sitting here spinning a narrative that a well-known scammer, because this is not her first rodeo, is telling the truth this time. And then she ended up getting attacked again after that. So she just keeps getting attacked, even if for whatever reason it was true. And I hate to say this, this is extremely problematic. But like at that point, why the fuck are you always getting attacked? Like, let's be real. Like if somebody's always constantly getting attacked like that, it's like, okay, something's not clicking. There's something wrong with this individual. Okay. A lot of us really have a problem with being wrong. A lot of us truly have a problem with being called out. We need to stop that shit. If we're gonna move forward as a community, we need to stop that. And then, of course, now we have the diaspora war.
Oh, well, you know, she's Somali, it don't fucking matter.
Well, if you're African-American, you shouldn't even care about this shit.
Bitch, we all Black. Stop that shit, kill that noise. The further division is so fucking annoying. Like, all of y'all, like, there's so many words I gotta block in my comment section and I need to start blocking y'all motherfuckers. All of y'all with that whole segregation caca, gonna get my money, bro. Like, every single, like, it bewilders me. When I say something y'all don't like, all of a sudden, oh, well,
you're Haitian anyway. I don't know why you're saying that. Oh, well, you had a father. You can't relate. Oh, well, you do have a loving man. Why are you even commenting on this?
Oh, well, you know, that's why you're gonna die alone. Oh, well, okay, well, you're a mammy anyway.
Oh, it's like, come on, bro. Y'all can't take constructive criticism, nor can y'all accept being fucking wrong. This shit low-key be making me want to make fucking fashion videos because it's like I'm so fucking exhausted. A lot of y'all, okay, shout outs to y'all that had common sense. Shout outs to y'all that literally were like, yeah, this shit don't make no sense. Or better yet, shout out to y'all that said nothing at all and waited for the shit to unfold, okay? And shout out to y'all that literally did come to me and apologize in my DM and under my old video. I appreciate you. But for the rest of y'all mush mouth motherfuckers, do not come back and subscribe here. Because y'all was talking hella hot shit. And I don't need that energy over here. That shit don't make, yo, that shit don't make no sense. A lot of y'all showed y'all asses, bro. A lot of y'all showed y'all asses. And y'all been showing y'all asses lately on my channel, and it's getting on my nerves. Y'all just don't like being held accountable. Again, go heal, go to fucking therapy, get some fucking meds, do something. Do something. Because all of this anger, all of this hate towards one another is not gonna do a damn thing for you. You're sitting here aiming all your hate towards each other, shit, aiming it at me. I don't give a fuck. I have a life outside here. I got friends. I got family. I got a man. I got shit outside this. When I turn off this camera, I don't give a fuck. I make these videos because that's what you want. But a lot of you guys, you live in this shit. A lot of you guys, you literally scroll all damn day and that's what you're consuming, and you take that shit out and you put it into your real life. Go touch grass. Or better yet, if you're in the north and you're experiencing the snowstorm, go touch snow. Maybe you will freeze your blend back into reality. Eh? Don't be talking that hot shit on my fucking videos and getting mad when I clap back, because bitch, I'll slap you in person too. Because none of y'all gonna say any of that shit in person. For those of you guys who kept sending me updates and expecting me to make multiple videos about this situation, understand, I will never make multiple videos about a situation because I was never pressed. You will never see me make more than maybe like 3 videos about a situation. Okay, and it'll probably be the beginning, maybe the middle progression, and then the very end. But typically it will be the beginning and the end of the situation. I have too much shit to do to be out here following people's lives like that. A lot of y'all are fucking bored. I am booked and busy. I was never about to follow every single thing this girl was doing and report on it. And I listen, respect to those of y'all that did that shit, because I was never about to find her family, find her friends, find her exes, and do all this goofy shit to interview them. So I knew she was lying. I ain't had to prove nothing. Shout outs to the ancestors, shout outs to the deities, shout outs to God, because my discernment is always there. I ain't been wrong yet, but when I have been, I've apologized for it. And a lot of you guys need to get that together. Accountability 2024. Critical thinking is truly underrated. It truly is. Like, it's very sad. Like, I understand the whole idea of believe the victim, but this shit is beginning to get abused by so many people. Like, stop letting people abuse movements for their own personal financial gain, okay? And I'm talking about all the movements. Shit, even, well, we all know BLM, that's a whole nother story. Black women are really out here dying, like, a lot. And a lot of people are not paying attention to that. But now we got this fucking dumbass out here lying. A lot of people are going to be out here like, oh, well, can't believe these niggettes. She probably deserved it anyway. Like, this shit is crazy. Overall, y'all, stop upholding these scammers. They ain't shit. They ain't never going to be shit. And we never going to be shit if we keep upholding scammers simply because we do not want to be wrong. And for the rest of y'all dumbass bitches that was in my comment section, fuck you. Don't come back unless you're going to apologize. If you apologize, come here. Come here. I love you. I love you so much.
Of course, I cannot end this video without saying shout outs to Iloho, Yanni, Chama, the Queen of Accountability, Tanya, and Grown Woman Vibes, and everyone else that actually stood to their guns, and everyone else that held this woman accountable, and people that actually had common sense, people who did not drag us and make us feel bad for using our brains in this matter, people who were defending us in comment sections. We deserve an apology. Okay, I am so sick and tired of seeing content creators and other people that were defending this woman double down. Like, it's okay to be wrong, bro. It's okay to be wrong. But most importantly, I'm gonna need all y'all that was talking crazy to run on me and all my sissies an apology. You feel me? I understand you may not like some of us and some of our other content, but right is right and wrong is wrong. Okay, we was right in this given situation. Of course, all the details weren't 1000% correct. However, sis was not hit with a brick. Sis got into a whole full-blown fight with a grown-ass man, and that's how she got a nut on her goddamn head. Not okay that the man hit her as hard as he did. I will never understand why people go and fight men. However, shit, I'm from the hood. Women do it here all the time. I'll never condone it, but whatever. We don't know what happened in the car. However, according to surveillance, she did hit him first. So with that being said, shout outs to those of y'all that was here using your heads.
And yeah, that's it for this video. All my resources will be linked down below. Thank you guys so much for watching me and always supporting me. I love you guys so very much. Please make sure you go get your merchandise, stream my single. It's always linked down below. And most importantly, join the Patreon for early access, access to a private Discord, and so much more. With that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye!